In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a dynamic text animation in After Effects, so let's get to it. First, I'm going to create a new 1920x1080 30 frames per second composition with a duration of 5 seconds, click OK, then select the type tool and type something. I'll do jump. For the font, I'm using Montserrat Black with a size of 200 pixels in all caps. After you type the word, what you want to do is to isolate each character into separate text layers. Here, the word jump has 4 characters, so I'm going to duplicate the text layer that I have 3 times, so we have 4 in total. So click on the text layer until it's highlighted and press Ctrl D 3 times, 1, 2, 3, so you have 4 text layers. Now I'm going to double click on each text layer and build the word one character at a time. So double click, first one will be J, U, M, P. Now let's align the characters so they form a word again. So for that, I'm going to select the selection tool, select the first letter J, move it to the left, then select the second one and move it closer. Hold shift so you don't accidentally move the letters on the y-axis like this. And the last one, move it closer. Now after you've aligned the letters, let's enable tile action save to see the center point. Drag and select all the letters and let's move them into the center like that. And then I'm going to disable tile action save. And after isolating the characters into separate text layers, we can start applying animation. But before we do though, you have to think, how do you want to apply the animation? Like in my case, I want the J to come from the left, letter P from the right, letter U from the top, and letter M from the bottom. And I'm also going to apply the scale animation to stretch the letter U and M. Now in order to do that, we need to move the anchor points of the letter U and M. So I'm going to select the pan behind tool, then select the letter U, and you'll see this anchor point, and I'm going to place it at the bottom. Hold Ctrl so it snaps this bottom edge. And the reason we are moving the anchor point is that when applying scale animation, scaling happens from the anchor point. So think of it as the epicenter of the animation. And in order to stretch the letter U only on this top part, we need to place the anchor point at the bottom. And we need to do the same for the letter M. So select it, but we need to place the anchor point at the top, so it stretches out to the bottom. Now, after doing that, I'm going to switch back to the selection tool. I'm going to select all layers and press P to bring up position. Click on the stopwatch to create keyframes. I'm also going to click away and then select just the letter M. Holding Ctrl, I'm going to select the letter U. Then hold Shift and press S to bring up scale and create keyframes for scale on the letter M and U. Now you'll see all of the keyframes have been created. Drag and select them all and move them to 20 frames. And then come back to the start, and here we can start moving the character. So I'm going to select the letter J and move it to the left, out of the frame. Then select the letter P, move it to the right, out of the frame. And before we move the letter U, let's stretch it out. So for that, we need to uncheck uniform scaling for both letter U and M. And I'm going to increase the second scale value until it stretches all the way out to the top, like this. And then I'm going to move it out, move it up, out of the frame. And let's do the same for the letter M, select it, increase the second scale value until it stretches all the way down, and then move it out of the frame. Now, if we preview this, everything will look very lame and flat. So we're going to fix everything with one simple expression that will be available in the pinned comment, or if you download the project file, which is completely free, you'll find it there as well. So here I'm going to hold the Alt key and click on the position stopwatch for the letter J. That'll enable us to add expressions. So I'm simply going to paste the expression here, click away, and let's do that for all of the properties that we have. And once you do that, let's press U 2 times to see just the keyframes. And here, if we do the preview, everything should look a lot better, but we can make it even better by adjusting the velocity. So for that, I'm going to drag and select the start keyframes, right-click any of them, keyframe assistant is easy, or you can press F9 as a shortcut. Now, while the keyframes are highlighted, let's open the graph editor from here, right-click, make sure edit speed graph is selected. And I'm going to drag and select the first point at the start. You'll see the yellow handle, you want to drag it all the way to the right. And then you will see another one underneath it, so make sure you drag that one as well. And then that's how the graph should look. Let's exit the graph editor now. And before we preview, let's enable motion blur. If you don't see this column to enable motion blur, click toggle switches and modes, and then enable motion blur for all of the letters. And here, if we do the preview, you can see everything will look very nice and smooth and even like bouncy. And now I'm going to add extra trails to the letter M and letter U. And we can easily do that using the shape tool or the pen tool. And make sure you set fill to none, and stroke should be set to a solid color. And for the color, I'm going for white, and stroke width is 44 pixels, but we're going to adjust it on our way. So here I'm going to come to the end. I'm going to zoom in and, you know, create simple stroke like this. Hold shift so you get the straight line like that. And now I'm going to open its properties, click the add button and select trim paths. And here, let's come to the start of the layer, of the shape layer, expand trim paths 1, create keyframes for start and end, set both to 0%. I'm going to move half a second forward, so 15 frames, set both start and end to 100. I'm going to drag and select the keyframes, press F9 to ease them, go into the graph editor, and let's pull both of the handles inward like that to get the snappy animation. Let's exit the graph editor. And now we need to offset the top or the start keyframes forward in time by like a few frames, so maybe 3 or 4 frames. And now we should get this nice quick stroke. So if we select the selection tool now, come to this moment where M is like halfway to its position, select the shape layer, and we're going to place it somewhere like here. And let's play around with the timing of it so it appears on top of the letter M. So here we need to decrease the stroke width a bit because it doesn't match the width of the letter M. I'm going to move it slightly to the right, like this. So here, if we do the preview, the letter M should have a nice trail now. So that looks good. Now I'm going to select the shape layer and press Ctrl D to duplicate it. Press R to bring up rotation and set it to 180 degrees, so it's upside down. And we can move that to the letter U again. Let's come to the point where U is halfway animated, so maybe here. Let's zoom in and place the stroke on top of the letter U. We might need to increase the stroke width a bit, so something like 44, yep. And here, let's play around with the timing, so something like that. If we preview, and that looks good, but you can see that the stroke animates before the letter is covering it. We obviously don't want that to be the case. So for that, we can simply shorten the start of the shape layer so it's not visible until this point, maybe even more. So here, it's still visible here, so I'm going to shorten it even further, like that. This is what we get, and let's do the same for the second shape layer. So you can see it's visible here, so I'm going to shorten it, something like that. And here, if we do the preview, we should have a very nice dynamic text animation. So here again. Now let's also enable motion blur for both shape layers. And if we preview, we should have a very nice dynamic text animation. And that is how you create one in After Effects. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new. Thank you guys for watching. See you in the next one. Peace out.